Hello everyone. In the today's session, we will discuss about how we can insert the record in the database. So let me explain the things step by step. Insert database record using insert command. Just like accessing the data in ASP.NET has the ability to insert records in to the database, as well let's take the same table structure used for inserting records, and the fields are tutorial ID and the tutorial names, 1 C#, 2 ASP.NET. Let's change the code in our form so that we can insert the following row into the table. Tutorial ID 3 and the tutorial name is vb.net. So this record we can insert in the demo DB, our previous table, which contain the two fields, tutorial ID and the tutorial name. Insert database records using insert command. Step 1. At the first step, let's add the following code to our program. The below code snip will be used to insert an existing record in our database. See this. First thing, declaring the variable. See SQL command as a command. Then SQL data adapter, adapter equal to new SQL data adapter constructor. Then string type SQL. The second thing, define the insert statement using SQL string variable, SQL equal to and double quotes insert into table name demo TV, and the fields are tutorial ID comma tutorial name, and the values keyword bracket where to specify ID 3 comma is plus vb.net and plus space. So these value we have to insert in the demo TV table. The next, define the SQL command. Command equal to new SQL command function where to pass two argument, SQL statement comma the connection, that is CNN. Then next, associate the insert command. Adapter dot insert command equal to new SQL command SQL comma CNN. Adapter dot insert command dot execute non query function, and then last, close all the objects, command dot dispose function, then CNN dot close function. So this is our code to insert record in the database using insert command. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now move to the next. Now see about the code explanation. Just I have explained the things. Now the first point, first step, create the following variables, SQL command, and this data type is used to define object. These object perform the SQL operation against a database. This object will hold the SQL command which will run against our SQL server database. Second, the database adapter object is used to perform insert, delete and update SQL commands. Third, we define a string variable which is SQL to hold our SQL command string. Next step is actually to define the SQL statement which will be used against our database. In our case, we are issuing an insert statement. This will insert the records of tutorial ID 3 and the tutorial name vb.net. Next, we create the commands object which is used to execute the SQL statement against the database in the SQL commands. You have to pass the connection object and the SQL string. In our data adapter command, associate the insert SQL command to the adapter, then issue the execute non-query method. This is used to execute the insert statement against our database. The execute non-query method is used in C# to issue any DML statement, that is data manipulation language statement, like insert, delete and the update operations against the database. To issue any table statement in ASP.NET, one needs to use the execute non-query method. And then finally, we close all the objects related to our database operation. Remember, this is always a good practice. So these are all about the code we have used to insert the record in a database. Now move to the next. Step 2. As a second step, let's add the same code as in the accessing data section. This is to display the recent table data in the browser. For that, we will add the below code to the demo aspx.cs file. SQL command, type SQL query, and the SQL data reader, that is data reader, and the SQL a string output equal to null. In SQL variable, we have to specify the select statement, select tutorial ID, comma tutorial name from the demo TV. This is your table name. The next SQL query equal to new SQL command. We have to pass the SQL statement and connection, that is CNN. Data reader equal to SQL query dot execute reader will read the data, and now we will display that each row using this while loop. See data reader dot read method, output equal to output plus data reader dot get value 0 plus space data reader dot get value next record first, then break line, and last response dot write of output. This can be used to display the record on the screen, and then command dot finally close dispose, and then connection close CNN dot close function. So this code we can use to display the records, or we can say the read the data from the database. Now move to the next. See, this is your complete code. Name is space demo application, then public partial class demo, syntax dot web dot UI page. Inside that protected void page load, object sender, and the event args as E. And then whatever the code we have just discussed, we can write inside that SQL command, that is SQL query, SQL data reader to read data with the help of data reader variable, then a string output equal to null, and SQL statement select tutorial ID tutorial name from the demo TV, the SQL query equal to new SQL command. We have to pass SQL statement and connection, that is CNN. Data reader equal to command dot execute reader function for reading the data, then while loop data reader dot read function, inside that output equal to output plus data reader dot get value first record space data reader dot get value next record, then break line, and finally display on the screen response dot write function of output, and then at last close all the objects, database data reader dot close function, then command dot dispose function, and then CNN dot close function. See the explanation, code explanation. We will continue our code by displaying the value. Using variable value of the, sorry, we will continue our code by displaying the value of the output variable. This is done using the response.write method. We finally close all the objects related to our database operations. Remember, this always a good practice when and finally we will run the code set, and the project is execute in the Visual Studio. You will get the following output. See this previous record C# ASP.NET, and last we have inserted, that is VB.NET. So this is all about how you can insert the record using insert command in the database in ASP.NET. Thank you for the today's session. I hope you have understood.